on this computer. Okay, so Kal Kadosh, we're going to start Bezrat Hashem, a new siman tonight. This is Siman Taf Ayin Zayin, Dinei Achilat HaFikumen. We're talking about eating of the Fikumen. This is obviously one of the most important parts of the night of the Seder as well. And it says over here like this, Le'achar Gamar Kol HaSeudah, after you finish the entire Seudah, Ochli Mimatzah Shmura Tachat HaMapah, you're going to eat from the Matzah which was hiding underneath the Shmura Matzah. Okay. And it says over here, Tachat Hamapa. And then it says, Kezait. Kol echad zechel lepesach. Anechal lasova. Yochelenu beeseba. And you're going to eat it beeseba. So basically, what's happening here, let me just, I don't know if you guys could hear me properly because I'm not connected with this. So again, we're going to be talking about, you're going to have a kezait. One of the kezait is zechel pesach ha'ne'echal la'sova, and you're going to eat it with hiseba. Ve'lo yivarech alav, and you're not going to make a bracha on it. Yezayil le'ochlo kodem, and you have to be careful to eat it before chatzot. Okay, then the Rama adds in a very important halacha. Ve'akdim atzmo shegam ha'alel yikra kodem chatzot. Which means that also the halel, right, should be before Chatzot as well. So, okay, this is going to be very, very important.
Is there a reason why he puts it in parentheses?
I'm not sure. Sometimes you will find the Rama in parentheses, even though it shouldn't be in parentheses, which means, you know, sometimes you'll find it that way, but it doesn't always actually, you know, mean something. Just one second. I'm having proper technical difficulties here. One second. No.
Okay. Now I've got it. Okay, everyone hears me? Now you can hear me better?
We hear you fine.
Okay, yes. Perfect. Okay, very good. Fine. So it says here like this. So we're going back to the share screen. Sorry about that. I apologize. So it says here like this. So this is a very important halakha that a lot of people disregard. Now, why do they disregard it is because maybe they think it's only the Rama, right? However, though, here it says that you should do everything before Chatzot, which means even the Alel. And some people come and they make their Haggadah according to the time amount, and they allot it that, okay, we're going to eat the Fikomen before Chatzot, we're okay. One second, Afikomen. Remember, it's before Birkat HaMazon. After the Fikumen, there's Birkat HaMazon. There's going to be the third cup. There's going to be the Halel. Okay? So therefore, you've got there another minimum of around 10 minutes. So don't think that you should only eat the Fikumen before Chatzot. You even have to finish the Halel before Chatzot. Now again, obviously we're talking about Lechat Techila, just like it is with everything else, but it's important to know that. Okay? Because a lot of people, they disregard that. So let's see the Mishnah Berurah. Mishnah Berurah says in the new siman over here, kezait. Lechatechila tov sheikach shene kezetim. Right? So it's lechatechila, a person should eat two kezetim for a fikumen. One for zecher lepesach, and one for zecher lematzah, which is eaten with the pesach. So here it says in number 5 in the footnote, mechen heela beshut chazon ovadia, shemin adin, eno tzarich lechot shene kezetim, vedai bekezait dov rov rishonim, umaran ashulchar ruch. Which means that Maran also paskin, like the Lachal Maaseh, the Min HaDin, you don't have to eat two kezetim. It's enough one kezait. However, though, he says, like the majority of the Rishonim in Shulchan Aruch, ויחבם באכילתו שהוא זכר לפסח וזכר לאכל למצה נאכל את אמו, וזיכרון אחד עולה לכאן ולכאן. And one zikaron is for both. So that means basically it's two for one. Okay? However, though, במחמיד לעצמו לאכול כשני זיתים, תבוא עליו ברכה. Somebody that's going to be מחמיד for himself to eat שני כזיתים, they should have a ברכה. So that's why I told you, for women and children, for sure you could be lenient, there's no problem whatsoever. Only thing is, for adults, technically speaking, even according to Rav Ovadia, the Minadin, or according to Maran, because Maran said Mefurash. Look at the Lashon Maran. Maran said the words, Kezait Kol Echad. He doesn't say you have to have two kezetim. It's a Mishnah Berurah that says that you should have Lecha Techila. Lecha Techila Tol Sheikach Shnei Kezetim. So the Mishnah Berurah is saying it's a Lecha Techila. Rav Ovadia is saying it's Tavol HaBrecha. Each one in their own words, but for sure, it's a concept of the of how much of matzot you should be having. Okay?
Quick question. I'm sorry, I don't even know if this is actually relevant, but the kazayit that you're supposed to eat is zecher le korban, right? The korban pesach.
Right.
That was supposed to be the main meal? Or that has nothing to do with the meal of pesach? In other words, what is this, the korban pesach? The korban pesach was intended to be the main meal of pesach?
Well, the Korban Pesach was the main meal on the night of Pesach, yes.
So after the Seudah, we eat the Matzah just to remember the meal of Pesach that we had, which is the Korban.
Yes. Zecher leKorban Pesach, haNeichal leSeudah, yeah. Okay. Here it says, how many Shiurei Kezetim are you supposed to have the night of the Seder? This is the Raben Tzion Abba Shaul. I'm going to quote, read to you the Raben Tzion. Raben Tzion says, HaMe'ader beMitzvot, somebody that's me'ader b'mitzvot, he should eat five shiurei kezayit b'leil haseder. Shnayim for the amotzi, one for the vokadio, and two for the afikomen. Nevertheless, you're lechatchila, you're going to be yotzei chovah with four. Two for amotzi, one for korech, and one for afikomen. Because min hadin, you don't need only one kezayit for afikomen. And the eating of the two kezetim is mitzvah min hamuvchar. So somebody that's very difficult for him, and he cannot eat only with three, it's also going to be okay. And a choleh that could only eat two kezetim, he should eat one for the hamotzi and one for the fikomen. And if he cannot only eat only one kezait, he should eat it for the fikomen. Uvechol often in any way, hamarbe ba'achilat matzah balayla zeh, harez meshubach. The more matzah that you eat, the more praiseworthy that it is. Shekem bechol achilat mikayem mitzvot aseh min haTorah. Every time that you're going to take another bite of the matzah, is a positive commandment from the Torah. It's fitting to minimize in other foods, right? In order that you should eat more of the matzah. So did everyone just hear that? So if people are going to come and tell me, listen, I want on the night of Pesach a huge feast, then a huge this, and a huge that. One second. The main mitzah is a matzah. So have as much matzah as you can. Every bite, everything is a mitzah doraita. Okay, so a lot of people are very oblivious of that fact. Meaning they just come in and think, okay, fine. I mean, tell me the minimum that I have to do with the matzah, and I just want my meal. Or I want the salads, and I want my fish, and I want my meat, and I want everything else. No, one second. The main mitzah is the matzah. Everything else is all extra. Okay? There is an inyan, obviously. There's an inyan of kvod yom tov, so you're going to have meat, but that's not the doraita. The doraita is the matzah. So that's much more important even than the Kvod Yom Tov. Still, you should have a little bit of meat for it to be Yotzei Chovah. We said yesterday about fish. We said yesterday, but again, the matzah is everything. Okay, so I hope everyone just pays attention to that. Okay. And I don't know if you realize, each one brought a different lashon. I mean, Shevra said, Lechatchila tov sheikach shnei kezetim. The Rav Ovadia said, Tavo alav berecha. And he brought down Harez Meshubach. No? What's his lashon? Mitzvah min hamuvchar. So each one brought down their own lashon, but again about having the two kezetim. Okay, next. Kol echad, every single person. Ve'af nashim chayevo bezeh. So even women are going to be obligated in the afikoman as well. Okay, that means don't think that it's only for men. Women are also obligated in the afikoman. Ala sova, what does it mean ala sova? Ve'en le'el b'siman tafayin vav si'ifal v'aga'a u'mash k'dam nusha b'mishah b'ra. So look above what we wrote down in the mishah b'ra. Tafayin vav si'ifal Bahaga, and that which we wrote down. Because the Ramah brought down, this is what we learned yesterday, that lo yochal velo yishteh arbe yoter midai, shelo yochal afi komen al achila gasa, o yishtakev yisham yad. You shouldn't eat too much, because if not, then you're eating the afikoman al achila gasa, which means not considered nachila whatsoever. So that's what he just says. So be careful with that. Okay? Next. Velo yivarech alav. You don't make a bracha on the afikoman. Shurak lezecher. Because it's only a zecher lekorban pesach and echal avikanal. Right? He says, v'katav ashla, ra'iti mibnei aliyah, shayum minashkin amatzot v'amaror. They used to kiss the matzah v'amaror. Okay? So therefore, you know, there's a lot of people that they like kissing a lot of different things. So the different of the mitzvot and all these things. So it's very, very important. You would kiss the matzah maror. Okay, this is what's brought down of in the Shla Kadosh. V'chen asukah, the same halacha would apply to kissing the sukkah, but it's really, it's at all when you come in, we come out. V'arba minin shebalulav. V'akol l'chibub mitzvah, everything is chibub mitzvah. V'ashre mi sheoved et Hashem besimcha. Fortunate is the person that he's serving a Kadosh Baruch Hu besimcha. It sounded more like of a Musar Sefer than a Halacha Sefer, but it's there. Okay? Now it says over here, V'yeh Zahir. What is Zahir? You should be careful. It said, V'yeh Zahir le'ochlo kodem chatzot. So you have to be careful to eat it before chatzot. It says in Mishnah Brura, Shekevan. Yeah? Shekevan. Sorry. I skipped out of Mishnah Brura. Nobody told me anything. This one. Yochlenu be'seba. Says the Mishnah Berurah, b'diavad im shachach ve'achlo b'lei seba. A person b'diavad forgot and he ate it without a seba. En tzarich lachzor b'leichol im kasheh alav achila. He does not have to eat it again if it's very difficult for him to eat it. So here we have the dalid in the Sharatziyun. According to Shitat Rashi v'Rashbam, it's mashma that the b'afikuman yotzin etzem ha-mitzah d'achila matzah. That means basically the main mitzvah of the achila matzah is in the afikuman according to Shitat Rashi v'Rashbam. But they made the takana to make the bracha at the beginning of the seuda, and you have to have in mind be'emet is to have the kavanah and the bracha to be poter also the fikuman, and according to them, for sure you have to eat it again with the seba. So you remember the stida that we asked on this? Nobody? I'm going to unmute everyone. No, everyone, nobody remembers a stira? We had a stira on this. Yitzhak, ¿te recuerdas? One second, I can't hear you. Hello?
I just joined. I don't know what you're talking about.
Okay, fine. So basically, we just said that we're talking about over here the stira. Because here in the Mishnah Berurah it says the diavad of a person forgot and they did not eat the afikoman when they were leaning. So then what happens is that they should eat it again if it's not difficult for them.
Oh, if it's not difficult.
So mashma the what? That if it's not difficult, then what? They should eat it. And what do we learn above?
Before about leaning.
Yeah, that if a person forgot to leave for the fikuman, what do we learn above? This was Siman Tafayim Bet. You remember? This was the...
No, didn't we say you have to go back again and if you didn't, even if you have to be dochet yourself to eat it. And if you're not leaning, no?
That's only over here. This is, you remember the Ramosha Fine team. And then Yitzhak brought down in the Dirshu the Shonei Alachot and others as well, that were almost saying the same rayon. We're talking about before Birkat HaMazon and after Birkat HaMazon. You remember? So this is what it's saying over here. If you remember there, you have a little footnote here. That's a stira, because I'm going to read it out to you, so that way you guys remember. We have to always do chazara. So here it says, Miu bafikomen, I'm reading it out. Miu bafikomen shachach leochlo beseba. Lo yachzor v'yochelenu. You shouldn't eat it again. Te'ha'asur le'echol shne pe'amim afikomen. You're not allowed to eat twice afikomen. So therefore, since over here it says you're not allowed to eat twice, so it says v'shut chadon odia ela shimadai lo b'dech b'kadom adzon. And it's ena achila shni akashe alav yachzor v'yochelenu v'seva. Ulam im la'achar im achila shni akashe alav en tzedich l'chok lachzor le'echol v'seva. And if you already did b'kadom adzon, you don't do it again. So if you remember, that was also the the shoot of, that was also the Moshe Feinstein and basically a whole bunch of Acharonim. Fine. Let's continue. So we just did now that this was the Sharatiyun. The Sharatiyun was very, very important because the Sharatiyun is telling you that you have to have in mind when you make the Alachilat Matzah during Motzi Matzah, you have to have in mind the Fiko Men. Because especially according to Shitat Rashi and Rashbam, that is the main mitzvah of the Fiko Men right now. That is the main mitzvah of the Challah and of the Matzah. Okay? Fine. Very good. Let's continue. It says over here like this. V'yezahir, a person should be very careful. Shekeven shu zecher lepesach, since it's zecher lepesach, tzrich lochlo bizman ha-pesach. Ta-pesach eno nechal el ha-chatzot. Which means the Pesach had an extra stringency more than other types of korbanot. That usually when we talk about korbanot that could be eaten at nighttime, you could eat it the entire nighttime. However, though, the korban Pesach could only be eaten until chatzot. So therefore, since it could only be eaten until chatzot, that's why they say that you're not allowed to eat the fikomen after chatzot. Does anybody remember why you could only eat the korban Pesach until chatzot? No? We learned it at the end of Daf Yomi on Berachot, if you remember. We said that since it was written... one of them was the Baboker. There was a whole bunch of, there were two or three different limudim. Why do we learn that Davka, the Korban Pesach, was specifically until Chatzot Laila and not for any other reason? Fine. It says over here, V'kol sheken kezaita nishon shomarachim alav alachila matzah, or the more so the kezaita nishon that you're going to eat on it alachila matzah, you have to be very careful shelo lachlo al chatzot. And b'diavad, if you were mitacher, right, mistakim alishonim, you're going to be yitzir chovar or not. Al ken yuchulenu v'li v'lech lev, so then you're not going to make a bracha. Even though it's in the Rabbanan, and if you didn't eat it before Chatzot, again, you're going to do it without a bracha. And if it became too dark, so a person, imagine right now, a person, he got too late, and all of a sudden, right, it could happen. A person, whatever, he slept in, he was busy, he was an emergency, he wasn't able to do it. So what's he going to do? It says over here, until it was right before Chatzot, he's going to do Kiddush, going to drink the first cup, he's going to do Netilat Adayim, say HaMotzi, Alachila Matzah, eat, make a bracha on the Maror, okay, Tefef Kodem Chatzot, and then afterwards say the Agadah, and afterwards he's going to Yisot to the Torah. Okay, until here we're clear? Here it says two different halachot. That was also the psak of the Chazon Ovadia, that you wouldn't make a bracha after the chatzot on the matzah and the maror. And also the next one, when it talks about the Haggadah, it says that even after chatzot, you're allowed to make the bracha of Asher Gealanu with Shem Malchut. Okay? Until here we're clear? So this is very, very important. Again, hopefully this doesn't happen, but this is talking about mamash, like until 1:15, that a person's not going to eat matzah or things like that. It's very...
Here they bring a nice Avnei Nezer.
Right. So the truth is, the Avnei Nezer is actually beautiful that you make a Tanai. Correct? That's right. Avnei Nezer with a Tanai. Which basically is doing, you're doing it like with Shitat Rabbi Akiva and Rabbi Yosef Galilei, that when exactly is the time of the Fikomen? Is it until Chatzot, and that's how we're passing Lecha Techila, or is it until Amud HaShachar, Alot HaShachar? So therefore, what some people do is that they make a condition, and the condition that they would do is that if we paskin, that you're only supposed to do it, right, until chatzot. So right now, they're going to, in the middle of their seuda, they would come and they would eat their afikomen. And they would, as if this is right now, their afikomen. And then afterwards, what they're eating afterwards, that's it. They're allowed to eat afterwards, according to that shita. So there's no problem. And then what they're going to eat afterwards, that's going to be only according to the next shita of Yosef Galilei. Is that correct? Something like that? That's to remember.
Correct. And that the whole thing of eating until that the taste of the fikomen has to be in your mouth, that's only until chatzot, because after chatzot, it doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter, exactly. So that's why that. But again, that's only going to be if a person's in a pressing need, that they're going to be too, meaning that he's going to be pressed for time. He doesn't have time anymore. So he's looking at the clock, he's saying, one second, we're only in the middle of the suda. you know, we're not going to get to the Fikomen. It's already too... By the way, you should know this happens many times in different places in the world. Here it doesn't happen because here, you know, nighttime is at 8:15-ish, let's say. And Chatzot is going to be at 1:15. So you do have, you know, 9:15, 11 to 12, you're talking about like 5 hours. 5 hours is more than enough time. I remember though in other places in the world, for example, when I remember we were in Gibraltar, it was chaos because nighttime was around like 9 or something like that. So therefore, by the time you got home, you started the Seuda and you started everything, and the Chatzot was around 12 something. No, maybe it was also 1 o'clock something. So you had like another hour less. So anybody that lived very far away and they started the Seuda and you have a lot of people at the Seuda, it was impossible. It was very, very difficult to get to Chatzot. Fine, okay. Now it says the next Mishnah Berurah, Shegam Ha'alel. So this is going on the Ramah. Remember that the Ramah up here said that also you should do the Hallel before Chatzot. So here it says in the Mishnah Berurah, Shegam Ha'alel, Rotze Lomar, Im Birchato Shemevarech Le'achareha, Yomar Lechatechila Kodm Chatzot, which means it's not only just starting the Hallel. It means you're finishing the entire Hallel before Chatzot. Here I have a number 4 that says, "Even nitakev b'kriyat ha'alel until after Chatzot, you could still make the berachah v'yalelucha, but you shouldn't make borei pri hagefen on kos talid, even though you usually always do." Oh wow! Did you just hear what I just said? It comes out that according to Shitat, this is the Chazon Ovadia. Chazon Ovadia says you could make yalelucha, but you're not going to make borei pri hagefen on the fourth cup. Oh, okay. Well, anyway, we don't make the bracha on the fourth cup. Okay, so we were lucky. But I'm saying, but if the Ashkenazim would have that minhag, they wouldn't be able to. Okay? Anything else to add? No?
No.
Okay, fine. Very good. Says Siv Bet. Im Shachach, imagine right now a person forgot and they did not eat the fikomen. He did not remember until he actually did netilat yadayim for my macharonim. Or he actually said, have lanu varech. Okay? So what does he do? You eat the fikomen without the damotzi here. Okay? However, though, if you already did bikatamazon, in niskar kodem shebirech borei pri hagefen, if right now you're going to remember before you said borei pri hagefen, yitol yadav yivarech hamotzi v'yochal afikomen. Do it again. You're going to have to do again. Netilat yadayim hamotzi afikomen. And then again, yachzor v'yivarech birkat hamazon. V'yivarech borei pri hagefen v'yishteh. Look at this. This is a nightmare. I mean, basically, for a person forgot afikomen, he was so involved in the seuda, he finished the seuda, birkat hamazon, they finish with Kadam Zon, they do Borei Pri HaGefen, or here it's saying it's a Niskar Kodam Shebirech Borei Pri HaGefen, over here. But then it says over here, Yitol Yadav, Vivarech HaMotzi, you have to do again, Netilat Adayim, HaMotzi, Afikomen, Birkat HaMazon, right? And then you're going to do Borei Pri HaGefen, Vishte HaKos. However, though, Yim Lo Niskar Adachar
Shebirech, he has to eat Kazayit?
Yeah, yeah.
HaMotzi Kazayit?
HaMotzi and a Kazayit. Well, anyway the Afikomen is Kazayit.
No, but it has to do a motzi. Oh, the motzi on the afikoman.
Yeah, the motzi is on the afikoman. Yes. The motzi is on the afikoman and he has to eat the kazait of the afikoman. He didn't eat the afikoman at all. He forgot the afikoman at all.
Two kazait?
Well, yes. I'm saying, mitzad the lechatchila, you always have the two kizitim, but that was the Mishnah Berurah, the first Sif Katan. Or the Tavoa la Bracha the Chazon Ovadia or Mitzvah Mir Mubchar of the Or Letzion. But you're right. I'm saying it's, you know, if a person's not going to eat two kazatim, you know, again, Mi'ikar Adin, it's kazait. That's the Ikar Adin. Okay, so if a person, mamash, he's not feeling well, or he's, you know, it's a women and children, Ikar Adin is Ikar Adin. It's always better. Tavoa la Bracha or Mitzvah Mir Mubchar or Lechatchila, according to the Mishnah Berurah, take two kazatim. But again, here we're talking about that a person forgot the Afikoman completely. Okay, now the second part of the halacha was that what happens if I only remembered after the kosher because of mazon? So remember, the end of my meal, I completely forgot about the fikomen. I started the Birkat HaMazon, finished Birkat HaMazon, Borei Pri HaGefen. One second, wasn't when's the Afik Omen? I had to do it before. So he says, then lo yochal Afik Omen, yismoch al matzah she'achal betoch ha'seudah shekulan shmurot enisha lisha. Right? Then I'm not going to do it. I'm not going to eat Afik Omen at all. We're going to see why. אבל במקום שנגעו לעשות שימור למצא מצא משע כצירה, אפילו נזכר עד אחר הלל, איתו לידע ויברך המוטיב ואוכל לפיקומן, then you should eat לפיקומן. So this is going to be very important to do שמורה מצא, and not just from the משעת הקצירה, but rather from the beginning. Okay? So he says over here, that's what he says here, the difference between משעת משע and משעת קצירה. So he says then you would have to actually do it again and do the לפיקומן. Says the Rama, "V'yachzor v'yivarech alakos ve'en lachush v'mash motziv alakosot." Right? So here, you don't have to start suspecting about that you're adding onto the cups. V'im ne'evad afikomen yochal kezayit echad matzah shmura acherin. Now, what happens if you lost afikomen? This happens sometimes. I still remember, it's a joke, because people, they come and they try to hide the afikomen so well. It actually happened. I remember somebody called me up after Pesach. They said, "Rabbi, I didn't know what to do, but we lost afikomen." I said, "How did you lose afikomen? It's supposed to be right underneath your thing." He goes, "No." They went, I don't remember who was, I don't remember if it was the Balabait hiding it for the children to find it, or the children hiding it for the Balabait, and then they forgot where was the Afikoman. So since they forgot, what do you do now? So says the Rabbah, if it got lost, take another matzah. That's your Afikoman. And that's it. Okay, let me see over here. There was a number one. Okay, here it brings down in the footnote that from Maran, it's mashma that you don't need to do netilat adayim the first time around. Meaning over here, when it says if a person forgot and he didn't eat afikuman and he only realized until he did mayim acharonim, or he said havlanu varech, he eats afikuman without amotzi. So here it's without amotzi and also without netilat adayim. And only after Birkat HaMazon does he have to do netilat adayim again. However, though, the not like the Kabbal Chaim, however, though, he says tavo alav brecha, you're going to do netilat adayim again. Fine, let's see the Mishnah Berurah. Okay, Mishnah Berurah here says, on bet. You're not going to make hamotzi. Even though in Siman Kuf Ayin Tet, some people say that if you already said, havlanu v'rivrich l'malkara k'nisha, havlanu v'varech, it's considered a esech hadat. And then if you want to eat again, you have to make again a new beracha. Here, ataka berachmana samchinen. We're being somech on the table of HaKadosh Baruch Hu. Then talui b'dato, it has nothing to do with us. We have to fulfill the will of Hashem. And for sure, Hashikha Garmalo Shi told your daughter, just that we forgot. That's why you didn't eat my macharonim. Or to say Havlan Varich, right? Umvarech. And you didn't do a sechadat. So therefore, here is a special halacha that even though you forgot and you already did Havlan Varich, you already did my macharonim. No, you continue as if you didn't do anything. So as long as you didn't do the Birkat HaMazon, you just continue. Okay, you do right now the Afikomen. And then that's it. And then you say the Birkat HaMazon. However, though, what happens if you already forgot and you said Birkat HaMazon? That was the second case, which is over here. You told your dad you have to do netilat adayim again, the tet. So it says the Mishnah Berurah on tet. You told your dad, the kemen shebirech Birkat HaMazon asach tate. But here, you already did Birkat HaMazon. If you did Birkat HaMazon, it's for sure hesech adam. Ma'im the primer adim shekatav, says the primer adim that says, the tol belo bracha, do netilat adayim without a bracha, especially if you know that you weren't a sechadat shelo yivarech. So here I have a footnote number 5 that says the arot we said that you should make a bracha on this netilat adayim, unless you're not going to eat a kabetza. Okay, so this is an afkamina for you guys that you told me one kazait or two kazatim. Remember, if you're only going to eat one kazait, so then anyway you're not going to make a bracha on netilat adayim. So here also is very, very important. Okay. Next, vivarech borei pri hagefen. You're going to make a borei pri hagefen. Vezek el kos lishi. This is the third cup. Ve lo yitzichu lelishtot kos ze samuch lebikat hamazon lishon. You don't have to do it after the first birkat hamazon. Ve lo tiknim kos lishi la bigmar achilato, because the kos lishi is only after you finish. Veze sheshachach leechol afikoman, and this one that he forgot to eat afikoman is like he didn't finish his seuda. So which basically means like this. I would have thought to say that the kos lishi always has to be after birkat hamazon. Here, he's doing Birkat HaMazon twice. He's doing Birkat HaMazon the first time because he forgot the Afikoman. And then the second time, after he already had to do again the Netilat Adayim, again Amotzi, again the Afikoman, or not again, you forgot the Afikoman the first time, and now Birkat HaMazon, and then the Kosh Lishi. So he says, nothing to do with where it is after the Birkat HaMazon, it's after you finish your meal. And after you finish your meal, it's after you're finishing the Afikoman. Okay? Next says, you should not eat the Afikoman. Here we're talking about if you already made the Birkat HaMazon and you already drank the third cup. He says, why? The im yochal was if you're going to eat. Now the Afikoman, yitzarech levarech Birkat HaMazon, u Birkat HaMazon tzarech kos. So now you have to make a new Birkat HaMazon. A new Birkat HaMazon means a new cup. Him ken, hu kemosif al kosot. Again, you're adding to the kosot. So a few of the achronim they actually brought down, yeah, they say as follows. That's only if you hold it, Birkat HaMazon needs a cup. However, according to our minhag, which to me is like the mandamer that says Birkat HaMazon does not need a cup, even now you could eat the afikoman and say Birkat HaMazon without a cup. So here it says that this is not actually correct. And the reason why is because Maran was the one that was posek above in this siman, that we do not need kos of Birkat HaMazon. So if Maran himself was the one that posek that you don't need a cup for Birkat HaMazon, here he still said that you should not say it. So therefore, don't make it dependent upon that. So he says, Ubiyer b'shuk David that he was choshesh lechatchila according to the mandamars, that you shouldn't make a bracha without a kos, because since they instituted the kos shlishi on the Birkat HaMazon, that's why they did it. And that's what the scheme of the Chazonish, or the Chazonish, Chazon Obadiah. So it comes out that according to the Sfaradim, the Chazon Obadiah and Maran, it's not like the Mishnah Berurah here, which means you're not going to eat it again. Because according to the Mishnah Berurah, he told you a Chumrah. The Chumrah was, no. Eat the Fikoman, do Birkat HaMazon, okay, again, but just don't do it, Alakos. And that's it. Says Maran, you don't do that. Why? Because he's being Choshesh Lechatchila, She'en levarech belokos. Rebbe, they did institute the third cup on this Birkat HaMazon. So therefore, because of that, you don't do that. Clear? Okay, if everyone's quiet, I'm going to take that as a yes. I can't see anybody here. Okay. Fine. Next.
So according to...
Yeah.
So according to the Mechaber... What I didn't understand very well the issue. The issue is you already
did the Birkat HaMazon and you drank the cup as well. And you forgot a fikumen at all. You didn't do the fikumen. So imagine you're in the middle of the meal, you guys got tied up. Instead of eating the fikumen and then my macharonim, you skipped the fikumen. You started my macharonim, Birkat HaMazon, third cup, and all of a sudden you guys are saying, okay, fine, we finished the thing. We're almost done. We have one more cup to go. One second. When do we do the Fikoman? Start looking. We were supposed to do it before Birkat HaMazon. What's going on? Now what do we do? So says Maran, if you already drank from the cup, Kaddish, no Fikoman. Says the Mishnah Berurah, why? Says Mishnah Berurah, very simple. Because if you would tell you now to do the Fikoman, again, you're going to have to do Netilat Tadayim, Hamotzi, Birkat HaMazon. That wasn't the problem. The problem now is going to be a cup. Because now that you're doing Birkat HaMazon needs a cup. So now you're adding on the kosot. So it says the Mishnah Berurah, but one second. That's only if you paskin that you always need a cup for Birkat HaMazon. According to how we paskin that our minhag is that you don't need a cup for Birkat HaMazon, what's the big deal? Do like what Maran said before, which means do again, Netilat Tadayim, Hamotzi, Eat Afikoman, do Birkat HaMazon without a cup. And then you're not Mosif al Kosot, and you got out of the problem. And that's how he finishes off. Says the footnote, that's incorrect. He says, why? Maran himself paskin that you don't need a cup for Birkat HaMazon. And still, he paskin by us that the second that you did the third cup, Kaddish. How could that be? So they explain the Charonim, the reason why is because Maran was Choshesh that they instituted the third cup on the Birkat HaMazon. And therefore, here you can't just do again Birkat HaMazon without a cup. The third cup was instituted on the Birkat HaMazon. It's a special institution on the night of Pesach that the third cup was on Birkat HaMazon. So don't say like a regular Friday night or regular Shabbat morning or Sudat Shlishi that you just don't need to have a cup for Birkat HaMazon. Here it's a special institution. So therefore, you can't do that anymore. So according to this, that's why he's saying that according to Maran, the second that you did Birkat HaMazon and the cup, the third cup, that's it. You don't do it again. And that was the psak of Rav Ovadia as well. Okay?
Thank you.
Okay, very good. So here now it says, Yismoch al matzah. So therefore, according to this, so what did you do? You didn't do the fikoman then. So how are you say chovat fikoman? You're going to be somech al matzah that you ate during the seudah. That means basically, that was considered your fikoman. Now, here you have a technical problem. How could that be considered your fikoman? He says, one second. He says, how could this be the fikoman? Afal pishelo kiven, az l'shem zeh, you didn't have kavanah for fikoman. Also, we already passed in also in Siman Tafa Yichet that after the green, you're not allowed to eat anything. Ve'ihu and he, halo achal achar matzah, he did eat after the matzah. Here everything is b'diavad. So here we're doing like a lot of b'diavads. Now, first of all, you didn't have kavanah, b'diavad, it's okay. Second of all, you ate, you're not supposed to eat after b'kuman, b'diavad, you're okay. So therefore here, you're already in the b'diavad, so you just leave it. Now he says, that which you ate in the middle of the suda, ha'im lo yash lo shmura klal b'toch ha'suda, but let's say you didn't eat shmura matzah in the middle of the suda, even though you did eat in the beginning of the Suda Kazait and Matzah Shmura, right? Kadim like Alakha, Choser Vofela Vokel Fikman, you do have to eat it again. The Lo Yatsa Mitzat Fikuman Bezed Abayan Shien Nehal Ala Sova. You have to eat it Ala Sova. Okay, so therefore he's coming and he's saying, and that's also the Shut Chazon Ovadiah is passing the exact same way, which means that you have to eat it also, right? Again, what is the connection though between eating it ala sova and because you didn't eat it ala sova, but that was at the beginning of the suda. The beginning of the suda, you were still hungry, right? So therefore, you have to eat it ala sova. So it could only be the kazait of the matzah that you're eating in the middle of the suda. That's also a question. What happens if you didn't eat a kazait in the middle of the suda? I don't know. Anybody thought of that?
What's your question? What if you didn't eat it? So what?
No, let's say you didn't eat a kazait. If you didn't eat a kazait in the middle of the suda, so then how could that be considered your fikuman? A fikuman needs a kazait according to everybody.
But is he meaning about that? He means the kazait of the suda.
Yeah, exactly. But that's what he says here. Look again in Shulchan Aruch. Shulchan Aruch says, "V'im lo nizkar ad achash v'ir bar v'gefen, lo yochal fikuman v'yismoch al matzah she'achal betoch ha'suda." Shekulan shmurot, okay, then we get into it that if it's not shmura, you have to eat it again. Now, why exactly? Says the Mishnah Brura, because you've got a technical problem, you didn't have kavanah, the diavad, it's okay. Technical problem, you're not supposed to eat after the fikoman, the diavad, it's okay. But then he says, why does it have to be betoch ha-suda? He says, it could not have been at the beginning of the suda. Why? Because if you ate it at the beginning of the suda, that wasn't eaten ala sova. That was eaten when you were hungry. So since you are hungry, you cannot use the original kezait of matzah from Moti matzah. So you need in the middle of the suda to be considered ala sova. You ate things afterwards. Okay, b'diavad, it's okay. Don't worry about it. Okay, fine. But one second. What happens if you didn't eat the kezait in the middle of the suda? I don't know.
He's giving you the word.
I couldn't hear. Sorry. What happened?
We also already saw that the kazait doesn't have to be eaten once and all. You could do many little pieces. So you assume in the middle of the meal, you probably have had enough to add up to a kazait, and then you're yotzei ala sova.
No, but that's the question. The question is, what if you didn't eat it?
What if after the motzi and matzah, that was your last matzah?
But if you didn't eat it, then
That's unusual.
If you didn't, it's not unusual.
Not really. After eating so much matzah.
If you didn't eat it, so then you have to eat it. I don't understand. I still don't understand the question.
No, because you don't eat it. Don't you see that it says that after you said the.
That's why. Right. That would only be if you ate. If you didn't, then you have a problem. You're going to have to do that.
So you're just saying that for sure, that means you already know that you did eat during the Suda one kazai, because if not, then obviously you go back to square one. You would have to split it.
Yeah, you didn't do it.
Okay. That could be. Ronnie, I do.
Yeah, but that would be a problem again with the kiddush, the third cup again. You would bring that problem back over.
Again, which
wouldn't you bring the problem again of the third cup?
That's only according to those opinions that hold that now you did an extra cup.
No, but he's asking. Well, but he's asking according to Maran, if he just said that after the Birkei Geffen.
That's because he yahal, so it would be considered that he didn't, and that cup that he drank would be like a drunk cup that he drank during
the Sunday. Truth is though that, but anyway, Adi, that's the question that we're gonna ask right now on this, Rama. Because again, let's forget my case that I just told you. Let's just focus now on the next case. A person ate regular matzah, non-shmura matzah during the meal. So what does Maran tell you? You have to do it again. Now says the Rama, Yachzor Vivarech Al HaKos. Ah, ve'en lachush b'ma shemosif al hakosot. So what's the pshat here then? Yud Zayin. Let's see. Or you know what? Okay, fine. Let's just continue. We're almost there. We're right over here. Let's just continue. That's Yud Zayin. So it's over here. Shimur lematzat itzah. Ve'lo achal me'ota matzah toch ha'seuda. She's right. She'yeh yachol lismoch ha'zeh shemikuman. Let's say a person didn't eat that matzah. So he ate regular matzah. He ate egg matzah or whatever it was. A chocolate covered matzah. Whatever he wanted. Afilu im lo niskar, even if he didn't remember, וכל שכנים niskar, כל שהתחיל לומר הלל, בוודאי אוכל אפילו קומם מברך ברכת המזון על הכוס. ואין כאן משום שתייה בין כוס שלישי לרביעי, ועשו כלכבן שמדרש, שכיוון שהשלישי היה בטעות, חוזר הכוס, שהוא מברך אתה עליו להיות שלישי. So it becomes now that that was a mistake, and now that that cup that you're drinking now, which is the fourth one, becomes the third one. But this is again, this is all talking about in a case where a person did not realize, and he basically ate non-shmura matzah during the meal. Okay, until after the halel. He drank the fourth cup as well. What is this case again? One more time. Here. Afilu lo nizkar adachar ha-halel. Yitol yedav yivarech ha-motiv yochal afi kuman. Mamash. That means if a person didn't have the shmura matzah in the middle of the meal, achalta ota, as they say. Yeah, you're gonna be mamash. You're gonna be in big trouble.
Why in trouble? You eat.
Okay, trouble means that you're gonna have to mamash. Exactly, you're gonna have to eat. Again.
Ah, okay.
Yeah, that's what I mean. You're gonna be in trouble. Meaning you're mamash. You're gonna have to eat everything. Okay, fine.
Yeah, the troubles are your fault. That's the trouble.
Exactly, that's gonna be a trouble. That you're gonna be.
The trouble is, we were talking about before, that if you ate the afikomen once you're full, like gasa, the question is, where is that line? You know, because you have to eat it a la sova, yet you cannot be stuffed. So, I mean, what is the sova? Is it once I ate a kezait, that means, I mean, once I ate the shiur of a meal, kabeita, whatever you want to call it, that means I'm a sova?
You're asking on what we learned yesterday. When we learned yesterday about the concept of what is considered achilat gasa or not achilat. Well, there the Mishnah Berurah brought down that it was that you were eating that you couldn't even eat anymore. And basically, you were forcing yourself to eat. So he says, when you do that, for sure you're not going to be seichel that. He says, if you're just pushing yourself to eat, which means that you're not full anymore, achilat gasa, it's b'diavad on you. No, that's what we said yesterday. Yeah,
the
Lashon
was Ketzatzeviya.
That's
what we saw.
Yeah, he says here, The Lashon was Ketzatzeviya. So basically, you're right, there's going to be two different opinions. If the guy is mamash stuffed and he can't even eat anymore, there's nothing what to do. That's not called even a fikol man. Okay?
So that could happen to this guy that has to eat again.
Yeah, it's true. That's what Adi was saying. That basically, if right now this guy, imagine, he also drank already the next two cups as well. That means it's true, he forgot the fikol man. But he drank the next two cups, and now again he's starting everything over. You know, so, I mean, he's again after gonna start now coming and eating a kezait, right? And then afterwards, say again all the cups. So it's another two cups as well, because we're talking about after the halel, he's doing everything, and then again he's gonna make on the course. Mamash, he's gonna have six cups tonight on the night of Pesach. Okay.
Wake me up for shacharit.
Fine. Ve'en lachush. So here we said you're not going to be in choshesh here for the extra cup. Right? Why not? Shekevan shemitchila haya. But since at the beginning it was, of course. השלישי בטעות, ועכשיו זה הכוס לכוס שלישי, ואף שאם כן הוא שלא כסידן, שהקדים לזה הכוס של הלל, שהוא ראוי להיות אחרון לסדר מהכאב. He says, בדיעבד, the seder is not מהכאב. Which means here, you messed up the entire seder. Because you had כוס שלישי, כוס רביעי, and all of a sudden, now again, you're having כוס שלישי. Because then it's not considered adding anything, because you made a mistake on another one. So he says, ah, you messed up the seder, because the fourth cup was supposed to be on the alel, the third cup was supposed to be on the kadam azon, now you have to do it again. So the diavad, it's not me'akev. So since it's not me'akev the diavad, you just leave it that way. Okay?
So it's interesting. So you just, all you have to do, I thought you had to do the whole thing again.
What's the whole thing again?
In other words, halel, everything, but it seems to be not.
Because
he's talking about a seder, so you see, if it's out of the seder, that means that I'm already yotzei of the fourth cup, so I just drink my third cup and I don't drink my fourth cup, no? Because if not, what's the...
Because if not, you're saying, then what's out of the seder?
Exactly, what does it mean, I'm out of the seder?
You are probably correct. Let me just check here, this Sharat Siyum, Tetva. That's what's mashma from here. Even though I have something.
Rani, I'll send it to you in the little pamphlet I'm making for you for the night.
What are you going to send him?
So they said there, so he knows what to do. I don't want him to get lost.
Ah, okay,
I'll write him all the little diukim that we're making.
Okay, fine.
I see you're on fire. ¿Qué cenaste esta noche? Lengua. ¿Qué te dio de allá?
What's the name of the book? Sedarim made ridiculously simple.
Like, just like the order of Kippur, no? Fine. The da.
Seder for dummies. For dummies, it's called.
Okay. Anybody else? We're taking names.
We wanted to keep it nice. We don't want to go all the way there, Sammy.
Fine. Veda, and you should know. Telefi ma shenoagin bechol hashana levarech mikadam zo without a cup. Here also, you should eat dafikoma without a cup. So here, that's also the psak of the Chazon Ovadia, which means that it comes out that beforehand, you remember we brought down the Mishnah Brura saying that you should have it without a cup. In this one, in the previous page over here, and then I told you that Ovadia argued because Shita Maran said that you don't eat it at all. Sorry, one second. Okay, so here it's saying that that here, you, right over here, you remember we said that you should have it without a kos. You should eat tafikoma without a kos, and you should, that means go against Maran. That means even if you, right here, if you already said the Borei Pri HaGefen, Maran says, "Im lo nizkar hachivirech Borei Pri HaGefen, you shouldn't eat tafikoma at all." And says the Mishnah Berurah, why? Just eat tafikoma now, and just don't make another Borei Pri HaGefen. Skip it out. You, because Amazon doesn't need a cup. So he said, no, Shita Maran was not like that. Maran doesn't hold to that. Here, though, Rav Ovadia is asking like the Mishnah Berurah, that here in a case where you already said the Halel, don't go out of order. You're just going to do the Fikoman again. You don't have to do it without a kos at all. Don't drink another cup. That's it. You were Yitzhak Chobah with the third and fourth cup already then and there, even though it wasn't Allah said. Okay? Or it was Allah said that it was just without the Fikoman. Okay. Anything else to add? I take that as a no. Siman tafayin chet. Okay. Shelo lechol achar achilat hafikoman. So this is talking about the siman of not eating after the fikoman. There's going to be two seifim. Seif aleph. Achar hafikoman, after the fikoman, en lechol shum davar. You're not supposed to eat anything. Okay. It says the Rama. Velo yicholenu b'shne mekomot. Don't eat in two different places. Delo adif meilu yifsik b'shena. Also, there's no difference if you're going to sleep in between or whatever. You shouldn't be eating it in two different places. So let's see the Mishnah Berurah. Mishnah Berurah says, "En lechol." Here it says in shne mekomot, "Lecheda maran lachmir b'ze." Shadechmir b'sivgat b'din shena. Okay, so basically also for maran, you're not supposed to eat the afikoman in two different places. Okay, and now it says here like this: אין לאכול, כדי שלא יעבור מפיו טעם מצה של אפיקומן, שהוא מצווה, בעצם זה you shouldn't have, in order you shouldn't be עובר מפיו טעם מצה של אפיקומן, שהוא מצווה על ידי טעם, right, אותו מאכל. Right? What is this? שום ובדיעבד, אם מאכל אחריו שום דבר, בדיעבד, if you did eat something afterward, יחזור ויוכל כזי מצה, you should eat another כזי למצה, שראית שמורה, לשם הפיקומן, for a פיקומן. So בדיעבד, let's say after the פיקומן, I came and I wanted to have a candy. And then I remembered, one second, I just had a candy, I wasn't supposed to do that. So then, again, eat another כזי מצה שמורה, for a פיקומן. Yeah, so now, Ari, you're going to be בלי נדה. Yeah, with all the מצה you have. Yeah, eat another כזי שמורה.
So Rav Shlomo Zalman Auerbach adds here the question that I had asked before. So he said that that if you're bolea, the fikoman, you're yatsa. Even though here you still need the taste, he said since before we said bolea matza yatsa, here also.
But I thought it's a different reason. That was your entire question.
I know. That was my question before, but Rav Shlomo Zalman, he permits it.
He permits it, but he doesn't explain why though.
No.
Interesting. Right. It's very doch. Well, again, meaning that if the ikar is achilat matzah and the achilat matzah at the beginning, you're yotzei chovat bala, it's very difficult to say that the last one you're not going to be, even though if you go by reasons, it makes sense. I'm saying that, you know, that you shouldn't be yotzei chovat. So, okay. I don't know. But he actually said it. Okay, Baruch Hashem. But I think, though, that this is though very important. As here it's written. That if a person mamash ate something afterwards, you're going to eat another kezayit matzah for a fikoma. That's important. Here I have a number three. The number three says that if it's difficult, again, you don't have to do it again. Or if you already did again the birkat hamazon, again, you don't have to do it again. Okay? Fine. Next. Shum davar, if you ate anything. Yeah? One second. There's too much noise. Hold on one second. Okay. So it says over here like this. It says, ulinyan shtiyah, to do with drinking, there's a machlok of the poskim. You should be machmir b'mashkeh ha-meshaker. For sure, in any intoxicating liquid, you should be careful with. Lechatchila nochol lizeh mikol mashkeh chutz mehem. You should be careful on any liquid other than water. Yekei gavna kemo shemvua lekamam b'simat ha-pealef mishabra ha-sif katan aleh. So here, obviously, we're going to know that it says the sif katan over here, number four. It says over here, v'ayin b'herotenu l'sham. Tafpe Aleph. Because it says over here, you're not allowed to drink wine, but water you're allowed to drink. So here it says over here, Kol chamar medina is asur, but then afterwards it says Ramada. Okay, so he speaks about tea over here. Okay, so we'll speak about it then over there. About tea, coffee, all those things over there. We're going to speak about it over there. Okay, that's going to be in Siman Tafe Aleph. Okay, so in Siman Tafe Aleph, we're going to speak about are you allowed to have tea and coffee or drinks after the Fikuman. But here it's Mashma, there's a machlok of the poskim. He brings down that for sure something which is Mishaker Yatul Lechatchila Bimachmin. But then he says you should be machmir on everything except for water. So water is the only thing that he's giving you a clear cut heter for, according to the Mishnah Berurah. Now he says velo yochelenu, okay, velo yochelenu lafikoman aval shar suda lelamba. Let me just check again. You're not allowed to eat a fikoman in two different places, but the rest of the suda you can eat in two different places. Yishnei mekomot buvadim bechader echad, the same halacha would apply in one room. And two different tables, it's considered like two different places. And the reason why is because the fikoman is zechel pesach. Pesach, right? Because it's written, you have to eat it in one house. So since you have to eat the korban pesach in one house, and the fikoman is zechel pesach, the korban pesach, so therefore you're not supposed to eat it in two different places. All right, he says it's not better than sleeping. So too the matzah is going to be the same halacha. Not only just like the korban pesach, also the matzah. Siv Bet, and we're going to finish with this one, right? Siv Bet says...
He just adds that you forgot to say Birkat Hamazon. Rav Shlomo Zalman says, what happens if you ate and you forgot to say Birkat Hamazon? So now you have to do Arakos. So he said, even like this, it's asur to add an extra kos. You do it on Havdalah. You do it Havdalah and Birkat Hamazon.
Again, where's Havdalah coming in? I'm lost. Sorry, one more time.
Let's say that it falls out on Saturday night. The Pesach.
Okay.
And so then you forgot? You forgot to say Havdalah in the Kiddush. I forgot. I totally forgot. I just said Havdalah. So he says that the Kiddush now needs a kos. So when do you do it? He says do it on Birkat Hamazon.
Okay, meaning add the Havdalah in the Birkat Hamazon in order that you're still
right.
Saying it on the kos. Okay. Fine. Mishi Hashem betoka suda. Somebody that's going to sleep in the middle of the suda and he wakes up, he doesn't eat again. Right, they do have to eat again. What happens if they all of them fell asleep? They don't have to eat again. Right, then you're going to eat them. If they're dozing off, then they should eat. I don't know what's this entire thing about people just falling asleep in the middle of a seder, but okay, fine. That's only if they started sleeping after they started the fikuman. But shina kolam laze is not considered a hefseh. Says the Mishnah Brura. Okay, betocha suuda. Looking at the divrei Rama baga, you don't have to eat again. The shina chashuva hefseh, but the shina itself is considered a hefseh. And the rabbis made it like you ate it in two different places. You have to eat it again. The kevan she yeter b'nei chabura yunorim. Since everybody else was still awake, it's not considered a hefseh for the people that were sleeping. However, though, what happens if he was only dozing off? I know shelo mishka b'shina kulehai. And if they're going to ask him, right, where do you put this utensil, right? And then they're going to remind him, he's going to remember. He's going to say yes or no. So that's called minamnem, meaning dozing off, right? But shena before this, right, which is within the middle of the meal, is not considered hefsek. It's not to do with hefsek. Okay, fine. So Baruch Hashem, we finished then. This is the next siman.